Hello, I'm Joe Ferguson. This is my studio in Weston. I've been doing sculpture for 60 years or so, and if you'll follow me, we'll go inside. Glass is a beautiful, hard, enduring substance. I chose it as my artistic medium for its unique properties to project colored light and brilliant hue. Light alone offered the creative potential of glass. The glass I use is stained glass, and it's hand-blown glass. I get it from importers in New York City, and I have quite a large stock of glass that I've used over the years, left over from commissions. I usually make things in brass rod, which is easily soldered. Most of my pieces are soldered together. So I start bending it in some shape or form. I start to fill it out with the brass rod, and then I try to make some way, like this man's beard and his hair, so that this can stand on 3 feet. Always need to have things sculpture stand. It helps rather than suspended. Then I start building forms around him, and I get to a point like this. And then I can start incorporating the colored glass, and the glass is just cut stained glass wrapped with a copper foil and soldered over. They're put in place, and I'm starting to get some form to it. The eyes are particularly nice. They have some sense of recognition when you look at them at the right way, because the light changes in the refracted glass. This is thick, 1-inch thick glass. Decide to cut a piece and put it in, find a position for it, cut it to the position, and then I bind it with a copper foil. This is the copper foil. It goes around the edges, and then I run a solder over it with a soldering iron. Okay, I melt the solder off, take the solder. Then I place it onto it, cover the copper foil with the solder,
You notice I'm careful not to drop the solder on my hand because it's still hot. I can pick it up. Then I can find whatever position I want to put it in. Say I want to do that. I use the solder flux. The flux cleans the metal. Whenever you solder or weld or anything like that, you have to deal with the oxygen in the atmosphere that wants to keep it from soldering. And there we go. That's it. Now, if I don't like it, if I look at it and find that it's really not the right thing, I can just go back. Heat it again and take it away. This sculpture is one of the small sculptures I've been working on recently. I'm calling this one Flower Garden because it looks a little like a flower garden. It enables me to use these chunks of glass along with the flat glass in a three-dimensional way. Again, all it is brass rod is the structure. I use brass rod because you can solder to it. Very few metals are like that. Yeah, this is the copper foil that is wrapped around and trying to find an area that will take the foil because you need something to solder all these other things too that come out from it. Symmetry is a good thing at certain times. Nature is full of symmetry. You're sort of working with that, but not being overwhelmed by symmetry. This is called Ibis. It's really taking Alexander Calder's idea of moving sculpture in the wind, and Ibis should turn in the wind. We don't have any wind right now, but this is sort of what it does. The idea is that it is constantly changing the colors, and instead of glass here, I had glass, stained glass in it, but then I couldn't show it anywhere because people were afraid of the liability. So I went to acrylic, and this is what they call a dichroic acrylic. It has a lamination so that the colors in it, it's all the same acrylic, but depending on where you're looking at it from, it can be a magenta, or a blue, or a gold, or a yellow. And that's what happens as it turns around. Unfortunately, the lamination starts to come off in 10 years, so it's something I've discovered. I was kind of curious to see how long it would last.
To combine both mechanical structure and balanced motion in an aesthetic form of sculpture is difficult. Gravity, usually our friend, becomes a wily antagonist. That a moving form can achieve balance is immensely pleasing. The very nature of balance is that it requires precision, an exact center point. There is no almost. Called a dichroic plastic, so it can be one sheet can be magenta or blue, or it can be a gold if it reflection, or it can be transparent, depending on how you look at it and where the light is. There's a natural beauty to hand-blown stained glass where flowing liquid is captured in its arrested flow. Each sheet of glass is a miracle in spontaneous design. Color and light was what it was all about.